The Cardinal by James Shirley and Other Works. Life and Works of James Shirley, the Last of the Great Race of Dramatists. Hello and welcome to The Discourse. James Shirley is a lesser known English Renaissance playwright who enjoyed a successful career as a dramatist during the Carolean age of English literature and continued till 1642 when the Parliament suppressed and banned the stage plays. According to Charles Lamb's, Shirley claims a place among the worthies of this period, not so much for any transcendent genius in himself, as that he was the last of a great race, all of whom spoke nearly the same language and had a set of moral feelings and notions in common. James Shirley was born in 1596 and died in 1666. He began as a dramatist in 1624 at the age of 28. Shirley produced tragedies, city comedies and tragicomedies with equal aplomb. Some of his major city comedies include The Witty Fair One, first performed in 1629, Hyde Park, first performed in 1632, and The Lady of Pleasure, first performed in 1635. The Witty Fair One is a city comedy that broke the humor comedy's pattern during the Jacobean age. This play is considered as the bridge of evolution between the humor comedies of Ben Jonson's age and the Restoration age comedies of Wycherley and Congreve. Hyde Park contains elements of naturalism. The Lady of Pleasure, like other dramas of Shirley, contains three plots, the main plot and two subplots. Shirley also used Thomas Kitt's style of creating parallel contrasting characters, namely Celestina and Aretina. Ephra Behn later used some elements and plot line of The Lady of Pleasure for her own drama The Lucky Chance during the Restoration period, which was staged in 1686. Some of the popular tragedies by James Shirley include The Maid's Revenge in 1626, Love's Cruelty in 1631, and The Cardinal, performed in 1641. We will discuss the characters and summary of The Cardinal. Characters of The Cardinal. The Duchess is a young widow whose husband died even before consummating their marriage. She is very keen to maintain her prestige. The King is the Duchess's kinsman and the leader of the court. The Cardinal is the King's favorite. Columbo is an army general, a nephew of the Cardinal, whom he wants to get married to the Duchess as it would increase his own political power. Valeria and Celinda are maids of the Duchess. Alvarez is a courtier whom the Duchess likes. Hernando and Alfonso are assistant generals of Columbo. Summary of the Cardinal. Though the play is set in Italy, James Shirley indirectly criticizes the English court too while directly attacking the corrupt Italian court system. The Duchess lost her husband before he could consummate their marriage. She is yet a virgin. Everybody praises the Duchess for her good behavior and chastity, and the king and the lords of the court want her to get remarried to a suitable person. The Cardinal is interested in arranging the Duchess's marriage to his nephew Colombo, who is a warlord. This marriage will increase the Cardinal's political power. The King appreciates Colombo and he is biased towards the Cardinal too. Thus, he promises the Duchess's hand to Colombo. Alvarez is also an able courtier, but he is forced to give up his claim. The Duchess discusses the man of court with her maids, Celinda and Valeria. Celinda praises Colombo for his bravery and skills at the battleground. Valeria suggests that Colombo is a savage. She praises Alvarez for his suave and genteel nature. The Duchess also likes Alvarez, but she is suspicious of Valeria and wonders if she is a spy upon my heart. Alfonso brings news that the Aragonians are planning to attack Italy. The Italian army is unprepared. Colombo, Alfonso and Hernando discuss the war strategies and the king announces Colombo as the leader of his army at the war front. Hernando is an equally brave and able soldier whose heroics is often eclipsed by Colombo. Before going to the war, Colombo meets the Duchess and bids goodbye. The Duchess maintains her prestige and pretends that she actually cares and is worried for him. The King also meets Colombo before he goes to the war and announces that the Duchess will be married to Colombo right after his return from the battleground. When the Duchess finds solitude, she curses her situation and wishes for Colombo's death during the war so that she may marry Alvarez, her first love. On the war front, despite the bigger strength of the opponent, Colombo and Hernando's battle tactics help them gaining upper hand. Colombo decides to restrict Hernando from taking any active part in the war at an appropriate time. When the Duchess learns about the initial success of Colombo against the enemy, she gets worried. She writes a letter to Colombo in which she pleads him to release her from the marriage contract so that she may marry Alvarez. When Colombo reads the letter, he gets mad. He wonders why the Duchess didn't tell him that she doesn't want to marry him right when he went to meet her before coming to the battleground. Ultimately, he sets his mind on the thought that the Duchess actually wants him to return as soon as possible, and hence she wrote such a letter. He too pretends the game and writes back a letter offering her release from the proposed marriage contract. Meanwhile, the Duchess plays nice with the Cardinal, as she doesn't want to annoy him. In the court, Alvarez succeeds in doing an important favor for the king, and he asks him to allow him to marry the Duchess. The king says that he already promised the Duchess to Colombo. However, if Colombo decides to release the Duchess, then Alvarez may marry her. Right then, the Duchess brings the letter of Colombo in which he wrote her to be released from the marriage contract. The Cardinal gets very upset and blames Colombo for ruining his future political prospects. Celinda and Valeria couldn't believe that Colombo released the Duchess. The King fulfills his promise and sanctions the marriage of Alvarez and the Duchess. At the same time, it is announced that Colombo, Alfonso and Hernando are returning from the battleground after gaining victory. The King arranges for a masque to celebrate the marriage of Alvarez and the Duchess. Colombo joins the masque disguised as a wizard and kills Alvarez. He takes responsibility for murdering Alvarez while blaming the Duchess for witchcraft and malice. He shows the Duchess's letter in which she pleaded for him to release her. He says that the letter proves that the Duchess tried to ruin his prestige. Thus, he claims that the murder of Alvarez is his revenge and justice. The king says that he is equally responsible for Alvarez's murder as he sided with the Duchess without inquiring about the letter from Colombo, but he refuses to pardon Colombo. The Cardinal asks Colombo to beg for his life, but Colombo denies and accepts the punishment. Rumors are rife that the king will ultimately pardon him for his heroics on the battlefield. The Duchess complains about the elections of Colombo to her maid Celinda, who likes him. Celinda defends Colombo and the Duchess says that he is a savage. Colombo was hearing all this from outside the room. He forcibly enters and says that the Duchess is not worthy of his attention anymore. He then says that Celinda is much more worthy than the Duchess and leaves the room. The Duchess chides Celinda for gaining the attention of Colombo, who retorts that the Duchess is now feeling jealous of her and leaves. Celinda becomes the mistress of Colombo, whom he promises to marry soon. Hernando meets the Duchess and offers help in exacting revenge for the murder of Alvarez. He himself wants revenge against Colombo for not allowing him any credit for the victory against the Aragonians. The Duchess says that Hernando is the only living man whom she now loves, and she will marry him if he succeeds in murdering Colombo. The Cardinal realizes that the Duchess desires revenge. He meets her and begs her to pardon Colombo. He tells her how important he is for the kingdom and how many good deeds he has done for the king. The Duchess seems to agree with the Cardinal that Colombo is a worthy man for the kingdom and the king. However, when the Cardinal goes away, she says to herself that nothing but Colombo's death will soothe her hurt. Hernando challenges Colombo for a duel, a sword fight, until one of the opponents death. Colombo doesn't want to fight against Hernando but agrees. Both kill each other's second man at the ground. Colombo is about to win as he snatches Hernando's sword. However, he doesn't want to kill Hernando and gets relaxed. Hernando takes benefit of the opportunity and takes the sword of his dead second man and stabs Colombo. Before Colombo may die, he tells him in ear that it is for his revenge and for the revenge of the Duchess. Columbo also tells him something and forgives him for his murder. As Columbo dies, Hernando decides to run away and hide. Celinda is too grieved after the death of Columbo, as now she is pregnant with his child without actual marriage. It becomes a reason for ridicule of her in the court and she runs away. The Duchess is happy about the murder of Columbo. She wonders why Hernando ran away and didn't come to her to claim her. The Cardinal is very sad and angry about his nephew's death. He plans for revenge against the Duchess. However, he finds no way to exact the revenge, as she is a lady, and even if he kills her, he thinks that death will be too little punishment for her. So he decides to snatch her virginity first, malign her, shoot her chastity with the rifle first, and then murder her. He visits the Duchess and offers her a tonic to drink. Then he tries to rape her. Hernando appears and attacks the Cardinal, injuring him while saving the Duchess. The King also appears and the Cardinal asks for pardon before he dies. He says that he was too angry about the murder of Columbo. He says that he already poisoned the Duchess, who will die soon, as the tonic he gave her was poisonous. He says that now he doesn't want the chaste Duchess to die and offers an antidote for the poison. To prove his point, he drinks some of the antidote himself and then offers it to the Duchess to save her life. The King nods and the Duchess drinks the supposed antidote. The Cardinal smiles and says that now his revenge is fulfilled, because the tonic wasn't poisonous, rather the supposed antidote is actual poison. The court healer comes and checks the Cardinal and the Duchess both. He declares that the Cardinal's wound was minor, but the poison that the Cardinal drank will soon kill him. The Duchess also dies because of the poison. The King orders their bodies to be prepared for the last rites, and the play ends. So this is it about the Cardinal and James Shirley, the last of the great dramatists of the Jacobean and Caroline age. Now we will start discussing the works of the metaphysical poets in upcoming sections. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.